Hello students, in this video we'll study about or we'll go through one more application of Gauss theorem. This we'll try to derive the electric field and electric potential due to conducting shell. Using Gauss theorem we'll find electric field, and using the relation between electric field and electric potential we'll find electric potential also. Okay, for that purpose let us consider this spherical shell here. It is a spherical shell on which charge is uniformly distributed. A Q charge is, let us suppose, a charge Q is uniformly distributed on this shell, surface of this. This is conducting shell. Conducting shell means charge will be distributed only on the surface. Okay, whatever charge it is given to you, given to this sphere, it will go to surface and gets uniformly distributed. Let us say the center is this point O, and this radius is R. Okay, then what we considered is, consider a spherical shell. It is very thin. Of radius R. This is center. Let plus Q is charge on the sphere. Okay, then we have to find the electric field at certain point which is outside. Let us try to find the electric field at three points. One point will take outside the sphere, another point will take on the surface, another point will take inside. So first, what I will do, first case, so for a point outside the sphere. See, let us consider a point here which is outside the sphere. Let us say this point is P. This point is P, which is at a distance R from the center. Let us consider this distance as R. OP is equal to R, where R is more than capital R because the point is outside. Okay, now what is electric field at this point? To find electric field at P, we draw a spherical Gaussian surface through P. Okay, how the spherical Gaussian surface is drawn? Covering that point P, we'll draw a spherical Gaussian surface. This is the spherical surface. That at this point, since it is positive charge, electric field will be away from the charge, perpendicular to the surface, this surface, Gaussian surface. And to find the flux through this surface, we'll consider a small area, which is ds. The direction of this ds is also perpendicular to the surface, okay? And E and ds at this point, they are in the same direction. So what we'll do now, let ds is the small area element of Gaussian surface, of the Gaussian surface. Okay, now what is the flux through that surface? The small flux, the small electric flux through ds is given by, now you see, once you go through this, can I go to next page? Okay, the small flux is given by, what is the flux formula? That flux will be So look at this figure. That flux, how it will be? See, d phi. That flux will be d phi is equal to E ds cos theta. E dot ds I will write, and this will be E ds cos theta. So what is the angle between E and ds? Since they are in the same direction, this angle is 0. So flux will be just E ds. So what is phi? This is d phi. Then what is the value of phi? Phi is equal to integration of E ds through the closed surface. E will be outside. Integration of ds is S. So this is E into, what is S? Surface area of this spherical Gaussian surface. What is the surface area of this sphere? This will be 4 pi r square. Then I'll get flux is equal to E into 4 pi r square. This let us consider equation number 1. This I got by definition of the flux. Okay. Now what is according to Gauss theorem? According to Gauss law, what is flux? Flux is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times charge enclosed within this surface. Within this surface, a whole charge is there. This plus Q charge is present within the Gaussian surface. So if it is like that, then let us call this as equation number 2. Then this flux from 1 and 2, these are the same flux values. Phi is equal to, phi is equal to. Then I can write from 1 and 2, can write E into 4 pi r square is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times Q. Then this E will be equal to, rearranging these terms, I will take 4 pi here, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by r square. This is the electric field due to a conducting shell which is at a distance r from the center, outside. Okay, now let us try to understand what is potential at this point. Okay, now this is the spherical surface. See, this is the spherical surface. This is a spherical surface. Charge Q is distributed uniformly on it. I want to define electric potential at this point, which is at a distance r from the center. From center, distance is r. What is electric potential? We know electric potential is nothing but the work done in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to this point. The relation between electric field and electric potential is, we know, E is equal to minus dV by dr, or we have dV is equal to E dr minus, or V is equal to minus of integration E dr. Okay, from where to where we are bringing the charge? From infinity to point P. That means this distance will be infinity in the beginning. If I bring that unit positive charge to this point, the distance becomes r. So what are my distance limits? Infinity to r. That means this will be infinity, this is r. Means if there is a unit positive charge at infinity, this distance was earlierly, initially it was infinity, and if I bring this charge to this point, distance reduces to r. That means I am reducing the distance from infinity to r. So it will be limits infinity to r. Then V will be equal to minus of integration infinity to r. Is it visible? Infinity to r. Then what is E? For time being, let me take this 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught as small k. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught, I am taking it as small k. Then this will be small k. Then this is q by r square. Then this minus of small k will be outside. Q is also taken outside. This is dr, E into dr. Okay. Then in the integral, what will remain? Infinity to r. This will be minus, sorry, this is 1 by r square into dr. What is integration of 1 by x square? Integration of 1 by x square is minus 1 by x. So integration of 1 by r square is minus 1 by r. So now we'll continue with this. This is V is equal to, what I got? I got minus KQ as it is. This is integration of 1 by r square dr. Then this will be minus 1 by r with the limits infinity to r. Then this minus minus will become plus. Once in place of r, we'll substitute r. Then this will be KQ. Inside bracket, I will get 1 by r minus 1 by infinity. Then I will get V is equal to 1 by infinity will be 0. And this is KQ 1 by r. What is K? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. Which implies electric potential is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by r. So this is electric potential at a distance r. Okay, this is the first case. See, 1 second, you observe these things. What is this? We considered a spherical Gaussian surface and we got this value. Okay, then this is the description we have written. Okay, this is at first we calculated for a point outside the sphere. See, this is electric field and this is electric potential. Okay, then this is outside. When I consider that point on the surface, it is very simple. See, on the surface, here if I, that means second case, when the point is on the surface. On the surface means if this point is on the surface, this distance small r will become equal to capital R. R is equal to R. Then what happens? See, this is on the surface. Field will be just, see, replace small r by capital R. Field is small r here. On the surface, small r will become equal to capital R. Then this will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. Then what is potential? See, potential that we calculated is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r. Then on the surface, it becomes 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by capital R. These are the values of field and potential at a point on the surface. When we come inside, for a point inside the sphere, see, this is very important. When we come inside this sphere, anywhere at this point I want to find the electric field, then this distance r from the center, small r value, this small r will be less than capital R. Then this is the spherical charge. See, let us see, this is the spherical shell of radius r, and I want to find the electric field at this point, which is inside. Okay, is inside the sphere. That means charge is distributed on the surface. To find the electric field at this point, if I draw a Gaussian surface like this of radius r, this point is P. Then if I draw a Gaussian surface like this, then what I observe is, in this Gaussian surface there is no charge. See, charge is lying outside the on the surface of conductor. When I come inside, there is no charge. That means according to Gauss theorem, so there is flux is equal to, flux through this closed surface is equal to q by epsilon naught is there, which implies integration of EdS is equal to charge enclosed within this surface. Inside this, charge is zero, so q is zero, it will become zero, which implies that electric field inside the sphere, at any point inside the sphere, is zero if it is conducting sphere. So what about potential inside? That is very good. See, what is the potential on the surface? Actually, how will you define the potential? What about potential on the surface? See, when I have the point here, see, this is the sphere that we considered, plus 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 plus. This is the positively charged, positive charge which is distributed uniformly. For three points I have to define the potential. See, this is a straight line. Let us consider this distance as infinite. Electric field exists up to this point. I want to define the electric potential at this point. I want to define the electric potential at this point. I want to define the electric potential at A, at B, at C. This is outside, this is on the surface, this is inside. See, if I say this is distance R, then for this point R is more than capital R. When I come to surface, R will become equal to R. When I come inside, this is the distance R, R becomes less than R, where R is radius of the sphere. I want to define the potential at this point, at this point, at this point. Just now what we concluded is, by Gauss theorem, electric field inside is zero. That means at this point, what is potential? It is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r. On the surface, if I come, what is potential? It is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by capital R. See, what is potential? Clearly, definition of potential says that this is the amount of potential, electric potential is the amount of work done in bringing a unit positive charge from infinity to this point. Against electric field, direction of electric field is this. Okay, we are moving the charge against electric field. This is the direction of electric field, away from the charge. We are moving this charge against electric field. See, the amount of work done in bringing this charge from here to here, let us suppose it is 150 joules. That means potential at this point is 150 joule per coulomb. The amount of work done in bringing this unit positive charge from here to here, again I have to do more work here. Let us suppose to bring it from here to point B, which is on the surface, let us say 200 joules of work is done. That means what is the work, what is the potential at B? 200 joule per coulomb. If I want to bring this charge from this surface, from this point to C, what is the work done? See, from infinity to B, 200 joules work done. Therefore, potential is 200 joule per coulomb. If I want to bring it from infinity to C, how much work is done? Infinity to C. Infinity to B, 200 joules. Infinity to B, 200 joules. B to C, 0 joules. This is very important. Infinity to B, 200 joules of work is done. Infinity to C, see, from here to here, 200 joules. From B to C, no work is done. 0 work done. Why? Because inside this field is not present. We are moving this, we are doing the work against the field. When field is not there inside, then what is the work done in bringing this charge from B to C? Zero work done. B to any point inside the surface, if we take all B in infinity to C, 200 joules work done. Infinity to B, 200. B to C, zero. Total works. Infinity to B, 200 joules work done. B to any point, D, B to D, zero work done, because field is not there. That means here the potential is 200. At this point potential is 200. At this point potential is 200. That means potential inside is equal to 200 everywhere. This 200 is potential at B, which is on the surface. That means B to C, the amount of work done in bringing this charge from infinity to B is 200. and the amount of work done in bringing this charge from infinity to any point inside the sphere is 200 only. That means at every point inside the sphere, potential is constant. And how much, what is its value? Of course it is constant. What is its value? It is 200. What is 200? Potential at surface. And its value is equal to that, or equal to the potential on the surface. That means everywhere inside potential is same, having same value as it is having on the surface. If surface potential is 200, then at every point the potential inside the sphere is 200. That means potential inside the sphere is always constant. Okay. Now, whatever discussion we have done, based on that, we'll try to write some formulae. Okay, one sphere we considered first. This is the spherical charge, spherical shell. Having some charge Q, which is distributed uniformly on it. Okay, radius of this sphere is R. I have considered three points here. This is A, on the surface B, inside this C. Okay, at A, see, outside, that means point is A. Outside the sphere, R is more than R at A. At B, on the surface, R is equal to R. At C, inside the sphere, where R is less than R. Then, what is potential outside? Field light. What is electric field here? Electric field is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. What is potential? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R. On the surface, just wherever it is, electric field is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R square. Electric potential is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by capital R. Then, at a point outside, inside the sphere, inside field is zero, and inside everywhere potential is having same value as it is on the surface. Okay. Now, depending on these observations, see, as I go from center this is r value, this is smaller value, this is smaller value, this is smaller value. This, as I go from center, small r goes on increasing. At center, small r will be equal to capital R, and outside, small r will be greater than capital R. That means, see, if I draw the variations of field and potential with respect to distance from the center, see, this is field, it is field, this is potential, this is distance r, distance r. How distance, field varies with distance, it is inversely proportional to r square. That means, as I go from surface, see, this is the central, let us, r goes on increasing, and at surface it becomes equal to capital R, equal to capital R. R goes on increasing, this is the center, this center, at surface it becomes equal to. Then, if I divide this distance portion, see, this is R less than R, this is R more than R, and this is surface. What is electric field inside the surface? Electric field inside the surface is zero. Electric field on the surface is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by capital R square. Then as I go outside, as I move, increase the distance, what happens to potential? What happens to field? Field goes on decreasing. That means inside it is zero. On the surface it is having this much value. And if I go outside, it goes on decreasing with distance. That means, inside field is zero. On the surface, it is having some maximum value. And if I go outside, the field will decrease with distance like this. Okay? Then, what about potential? Potential inside the surface is 1 by 4 pi everywhere. Everywhere inside it is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by capital R. Inside. Constant value it is having. This much constant value. What is this constant value? This is kq by capital R. Here also at inside, at every point it is constant. When I come to the surface, it becomes, it is also kq by capital R. Then when I go outside, this is outside. When I go outside, potential goes on decreasing with distance. See, potential goes on decreasing with distance. Inside, it is constant. Outside, it is inversely proportional to distance. What about field? It is inside zero. At surface, it is having some maximum value, kq by r square. Then when I go out, it is inversely proportional to r square. Here also potential is kq by r. When I go out, potential is inversely proportional to r. See, these are the variations of electric field and electric potential measuring the distance r from the center. So, what are the things that we have studied? This is the first case where we found out the, where we determined electric field outside. Okay, this is the description I have written. By definition of the flux, I calculated the flux. By Gauss theorem, another equation we made. Then this field equation we got 1 by 4 pi epsilon q by r square. From this, I calculated the potential. Potential using this relation. Using this relation. Okay. This we done for outside. See, when the point is on the surface, just replace small r to capital R by capital R. This is field on the surface and this is potential. Inside electric field is zero. If electric field is zero, it does not mean that inside potential is also zero. Potential inside is, see, on the surface whatever potential is there, 200. That means work done is zero inside everywhere. That means whatever it is on the surface, that value will be there at every point inside the surface. Okay, then this is the table that we written. This is outside field, outside potential, on the surface field, on the surface potential, inside field is zero, inside potential is same as that of on the surface. Okay, constant value. These are the variations of field and potential with distance. Inside field is zero, outside it decreases with as inversely proportional to r square, and inside potential is constant and outside it decreases inversely with respect to r. Okay, this is about electric field and potential due to a spherical shell, or it is conducting shell, or it can be also treated as metallic sphere. Okay, inside field is zero. Hollow metallic sphere, whenever it is mentioned that it is hollow metallic sphere, hollow metallic sphere, inside it is hollow and it is a metal surface, it is conducting shell. So hollow metallic sphere, electric field inside is zero. You remember this point. Okay, it will be helpful. Thank you.